Costanzo Prebe was my teacher in Turin. I met him the first time in 2007 when I was really young. He gave a lesson about 68 together with Gianni Vattimo, who was also a teacher of mine in Turin. They were really friends, even if they had a really different ways of thinking, but they were really friends. And since I met him, I decided that he had to be my teacher, because the way he was reading Marx, the way he was speaking about the present, the way he was trying with Hegel to think about the present with philosophy, were for me a surprise. Costanzo Preve was especially a scholar of Marx and the Greek tradition, also of Hegel. I think that Costanzo Preve was like an ancient Greek put into the contemporary world. For Costanzo Preve there was not an inside world in philosophy and an outside world from philosophy. He always spoke about philosophy every day, in every second of his life. Everything for Preve was an object of philosophical thinking. I think that the most important heritage that we should take from Preve is his theory of capitalism. For Preve, capitalism is based on three dialectical figures. He was a scholar of Hegel, so he always used dialectical thinking. Three different figures of capitalism. The first one, the abstract capitalism, is the capitalism that creates itself, the capitalism that must create the new working class, the capitalism that has to create a new way of thinking with individuals without community, since Descartes, cogito ergo sum, passing through Hobbes, homo homini lupus, passing through John Locke, the new homo economicus, till David Hume, the man that desires, that always desires, that doesn't exist in his nature, is like a theater where the desires pass. This is the first phase of capitalism. The second phase of capitalism, according to Preve's theory, is the one with the dialectical reaction against capitalism. And this dialectical reaction is based on two figures that Preve takes from Hegel's Phenomenology of Mind. The first figure is the struggle for the recognition. Hegel says, Kampf Anerkennung, the fight for the recognition. The fight for the recognition is the fight that the proletariat makes in capitalism against the way of exploitation, the class struggle, the servant that reacts against the master in Hegel's Phenomenology. The second figure is the one of unhappy consciousness. Hegel says, unglückliches Bewusstsein, the unhappy consciousness, I think, in English. This is the key to understand the real nature of bourgeoisie. Bourgeoisie, according to Preve's theory, is not just the class that is ruling into capitalism. Of course, the bourgeoisie is the ruling class, but bourgeoisie has also an unhappy conscience, because bourgeoisie would like to create the universal emancipation, the universal freedom, according to to the point of view of Kant, according to the point of view of Voltaire, and so on. So, bourgeoisie is a class that makes the suffering experience of the unhappy consciousness. Bourgeoisie would like to have the universal freedom, universal emancipation, but the capitalistic world doesn't do that. Creates oppression, creates exploitation, alienation, colonialism, imperialism, and so on. So bourgeoisie is a dialectical class. Some fragments of bourgeoisie, of course, are for capitalism, because bourgeoisie is the ruling class in capitalism, but some fragments of bourgeoisie are against capitalism, because they want to create the universal emancipation. So the dialectical moment in the second phase, of capitalism is made by the union of the fight for recognition, the class struggle made by proletariat, and the unhappy consciousness of bourgeoisie. Karl Marx was a member of bourgeoisie, we know. Like the Cleanamen by Epicurus, he had a deviation. He passed to the fight of proletarians because he thought that that fight could be the way of setting free humanity from capitalism. The fight made by proletariat, the fight for recognition, is the fight that is against capitalism, and so is the fight that can set free humanity from capitalism. This is why some fragments of bourgeoisie pass to the proletarian struggle. Ernst Bloch, who was a scholar of Marx, in his main work, in German is Das Prinzip Hoffnung, the hope I think in English, says that it's just on this base that we can understand why so many people loved the red flag, even if they had no material interest in doing so. This is the history of 19th century, the 20th century. Karl Marx, for instance. So, the dialectical capitalism of the second phase, based on the struggle against capitalism, made by the union of unhappy conscious and the struggle for the recognition, is died when, according to Prevost's theory, when a new form of capitalism become ruling. And this new kind of capitalism become ruling since 68. So Prevost's theory meets here Kluskart's theory, even if Prevost didn't like so much Kluskart, and also meets here Pasolini's theory. Prevost loved Pasolini. Because the new capitalism since 68 sets in itself free from the dialectical element. It puts away the bourgeoisie and the unhappy consciousness of bourgeoisie and sets away proletariat world. Since 68, the left doesn't fight anymore for the emancipation of the proletariat, fights no more for setting free the humanity from capitalism. Since 68, the new rainbow left, individualistic and post-Marxist, fights just for individual rights of the consumers inside the capitalism. We had, since 68, the economization of the conflict. The workers don't fight against capitalism, they fight just to have better wage inside capitalism. So the working class is normalized, is defeated in the consciousness. They had, since 68, the dream of being consumerist, not to be away from capitalism. And the bourgeoisie, of course, since 68, doesn't exist anymore. We have just a new ruling class without an happy consciousness, a new ruling class that is not the bourgeoisie, is without any values of the bourgeoisie, without any unhappy consciousness of the bourgeoisie. This is our new absolute capitalism, with on the top the financial ruling class and like a dominated class, the new, so to say, the new multitude based on the proletariat and on the bourgeoisie, that become just like a precariat, just like a multitude with no consciousness, with no values, that believe that they should have more free market, more European Union. They are like the slaves in Plato's cave. They love their chains. They are ready to fight against whatever could destroy those chains, and they are ready, like Spinoza said in his political work, to fight in defense of their own slavery. This is the point. And Costanzo Preve, of course, in his theory, was really near to Hegel. It's natural, so also really he really appreciated Marx. He wrote many books about Karl Marx's theory, but also, this is a point I wanna speak about, was really near to the ancient Greek philosophical culture. Costanzo Preve himself was both Italian and Greek, because his mother was from Greece. He spoke a perfect modern Greek, Preve, also the ancient one, of course. Preve always spoke about the Greeks, and he thought that the most important philosophical value we have to take from the Greeks was the one of the limit, the metaphysics of limit. He usually spoke about this point when he spoke about Aristotle, Plato, Heraclitus, Epicurus. This was, according to Preve, the central point of the Greek world, the value of limit, the metaphysics of limit. And this is a point he underlined very well in his work about the history of philosophy. One of the last works written by Preve was a great history of philosophy, better, a counter-history of philosophy. He started from the Greeks and he arrived into the contemporary world. And he used, of course, the categories of his periodization of capitalism. Descartes, Locke, Hume in the first phase, Marx, Fichte, Hegel were the protagonists of the dialectical phase. Also Fichte was really important for Preve, maybe also more than Marx for many aspects. And then the new ultra-capitalistic, absolute capitalistic phase of today, in which the post-modernist theories played an important role to justify the real capitalistic exploitation, or as Friedrich Jameson would say, the postmodernism is the cultural logic of late capitalism. So also Preve said this. So is according to my modest, my honest opinion, in Italy in the last century we had three great Marxist thinkers, and they were Antonio Gramsci, Pierpaolo Pasolini and Costanzo Preve. These three are the most important Marxist theorists in Italy in the last century. And of course they had many aspects in common, but also this one. They were all three defeated. Gramsci, we know, he died in that way. Pasolini also was killed, was brutally killed. Costanzo Preve was not killed, but in a symbolic way he was killed, because nobody paid attention to his theories. He was like to be like a stranger in Fatherland. Nobody paid attention to his philosophical reflection. Che ne dici?